So in this video, we are going to see about the T flip-flop. It is similar to D flip-flop, where in D flip-flop, you have both SR flip-flop, both are connected to a single input, and you don't have the, you never achieve the condition of both 0, 0 or both 1. Okay, so the trace condition is avoided, that forbidden condition is avoided. So that forbidden condition, otherwise it is called as trace condition. Okay, in JK flip-flop, again, you have separate input, and this can be eliminated in a T flip-flop, where this is a JK flip-flop only, but here the both the J and K are connected to 1, and you achieve the result, let us make a D flip-flop. So when T is 0, okay, there will be no change. When it is 0, there will be no change. It is said to remain in the previous state. When T is 1, we have the complement. Okay, they will stop it. Now we'll see the output. Now we'll check the logic circuit. Anyway, this is the, I think this is the same circuit. Only thing is we have to connect both J and K together. So we'll do that. And this is said to be T flip-flop. Here we have the, everything is same. Okay, so now this is K and this is J. Now we'll check the output. Now this is doing the positive negative. Let us make first just to be negative checking because I don't want anything to change. Okay, so now here, let me put 0. So what is the output it has to be? See here, when I give 0, what will happen? No change, right? See here, there is no change. It remains the same shape. 0 and 1. Now I give a 1. Now it is negative exchange, so there is no change. Now I give positive. So now what happened? It becomes 1 and 0. Now again I'm giving. Now what happened? Toggling takes place. The same 1 goes to both. So see here, during the next negative exchange, positive exchange, it toggles. So either 0 is given for both. So when 0 is given for both, what happens? It remembers the previous input. Okay, it remembers, it stores the data. When both are 1, the toggling takes place. So here. Okay, the toggling takes place. So, in this, what happened? Only this state, 0, 0 and 1, 1 can be seen in this T flip-flop. So that is the main difference between the JK flip-flop and T flip-flop. Now, we'll see the difference between the combinational circuit and sequential circuit. The first point, the output of combinational circuit depends only on the present input. This is the first condition. The output of the sequential circuit depends on both present inputs and present state as well as the previous output. The feedback path is not present. That is, the output of the flip-flop is again sent and given as an input. That is what we have seen in the flip-flop. Whereas the feedback path is not present in the combination circuit. If we see multiplexer, demultiplexer, encoders and all, the output is not given as again as an input. Whereas here it is present in sequential circuit. In combination circuit, memory is not there. But here memory plays an important role and it is required. The clock signal is not required for combinational circuit, whereas the clock signal is required for sequential circuits. Here the clock signal is a must. The combination circuit is simple to design, whereas here it is not that simple. It is a little bit complex circuit. The complexity increases. That is what these are the main difference between a combinational and sequential circuits.